1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2
That's cold.
But you didn't know that. You didn't know that I had the record and I had everything that
you did. Did you notice that we had musical implements in our record?
That's why I had the record.
It was musical. It was not just a regular record where it was sampling and just scratching and taking other people's music, but it was live musicians. And 90% of those musicians played in the church. The boy that played on What's My Name, Snoop Doggy Dog, Pork Chops. Daddy was a minister. He came up out of the church.
Pork Chop.
Yes, sir.
That's a good name for a musician.
Yes, sir.
Good name. I bet he was dope.
Oh, boy, he was something special.
So then, Snoop, then let me ask you this question then. With that type of history coming from church and the type of church influences that you were around, how old were you when you felt the Lord knocking on your heart? Like, how old were you?
Man, probably when I was like 9 years old. I used to go to church all the time, and my mother used to catch the Holy Ghost, and people used to always laugh and make fun and be like, your mama finna fall out again. And, you know, because we didn't understand what catching the Holy Ghost was back then. So one particular Sunday, I caught the Holy Ghost, like not falling out and all that, but I felt some kind of...
But you knew something happened.
I felt some kind of way, and I was
something happened.
I need to be doing more right than wrong.
Wow.
Whenever I'm in life, and I need to take God with me everywhere I go.
Wow.
No matter what I do. So when I did decide to make wrong decisions and join a gang and sell drugs, I had God right there with me.
You had that knock. And what was very interesting about when I met you in 98 and when you said that you wanted to hook up, because you don't remember, but you said, yo, man, I want to hook up and do some music
with you. Yes.
You said that in 98.
Yes.
And I was scared to death because I know that on the West Coast, y'all were coming out of that whole death row movement and it was still fresh, it was still new, and it scared me to death, but because it was so real and what was happening. But even then, the passion in your heart and the humility that you as a big star showed to me really, really, really caught my attention. And wifey was with me. You don't even know, but wifey, she was like, yo, man, he was so nice. And I was like, I can't believe how nice it was, because you didn't know that the connection with your faith and the humanity that you had was going to show up like that. But then I saw you be like that with everybody. Mm-hmm. And I think that that has been the reputation that you've had. I think the reputation that when you hear people talk about you, it's the kindness of your heart and the spirit of love that you've always shown. Now, were you even like that when you was trying to be about the block? Like, were you the nice?
I'm gonna be honest with you.
Were you the nice thug? Were you?
I'm gonna be honest. I can share this with you because we being real.
100.
It was the time when I was supposed to do something, and I just didn't want to do it. And usually, when you don't do it, you get DP'd. You get disciplined. But they allowed me to not be disciplined and to walk out of it because I felt like I didn't want to do it. They wanted me to do something violent to somebody, and I just couldn't do it.
Wow.
And I was like, I can't do it. And normally they would call you a punk or a buster. But they was like, all right, cuz, you cool. Go ahead and do your rap thing. Because it's like they must have seen what I seen, that I really wasn't cut out for that.
Or they could have even seen God's hand on your life even then.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Because remember, is that I firmly believe that everything physical and visible is first preceded by that which is spiritual and invisible. Mm. So before we're human beings, we're spiritual beings.
Righteous.
And then there's a spiritual component behind everything that's going on in our lives. So it's like God's hand is watching over us when we don't even know it.
You're so right, because it was a time when, once upon a time, when we was on the spot and we had one of the homies, and he was a real active gangbanger. But he would pray every time he would do something.
That's crazy.
And it was like blowing our minds that he would do so much wrong, but he would pray before he went to do wrong, and then he would always make it out.
But you know, to Snoop, that's how I was with females. That's how I was with females. I came to the Lord when I was about 15. And, my whole life, I had a really promiscuous past. I was adopted. I don't know if you know that. I was adopted when I was four by a 64-year-old lady. She was a widow, 64-year-old lady, and she had a fourth-grade education, Stu. And she raised me by, and she paid for my piano lesson by recycling old newspapers and beer cans. She would have the neighbors save up the newspapers, beer cans, and pay for my piano lesson. We was on government aid, food stamps, government cheese. And my mom and daddy abandoned me. My daddy was never there. He gave me a haircut once when I was 7 when his daddy died for the funeral. Negro came in, got my haircut, went to the funeral, never saw him again. My mama was in and out, her boyfriend, they would come back every now and then. It was never a mom in my life. And I remember even being young, knowing that something bigger was happening in my life. Something was going on in my life that I could not explain. Mm. And with you having all these moments where you could see God doing that in your life, is I gotta ask you though, even though you had the style and the flow of cadence, did you ever consider, and I know it's gonna sound corny, did you ever consider, like, what they called back then gospel rap or Christian rap? Did you ever even think of that? Did that ever cross your mind?
I did a gospel rap when I was in church, probably like in 1984.
Do you remember it?
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus,
That's all you got? That's all you got?
I can't remember. It's 84. Come on, God.
But I'm giving you this beat, though. I'm giving you this cafeteria beat.
Give it to me. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus. I get it with this, the little miss. This is legitimate. Let me just spit a bit. Cause it's about the man up top. I mean, Jesus is the one. He is the only one to look out for you 7 days a week when you're down on your knees and you need help. It's just the one that you can call on. Yes, my Savior, my God. Break down and give him his praises. 84.
Now I just did a beat for Snoop. That is probably gonna be like the highlight of my hip hop history. I can't believe I just did a beat.
That's like me and you in the cafeteria getting busy back in the day.
That's how you do with your jellies on and with your Levi's on.
Yeah, I couldn't let you make the beat without me putting something to it. Come on, dog. I had to put something to it.
So then why did it not ever move from that to, like, trying to be that dude that would, like, spit for God? Like, was it?
You know what I believe that my calling was to go minister to the streets first and then get to people and then tell them about God's word once I get their attention.